You've just entered the theater of an alien sky. If the words and images seem strange to you, there's a reason for this. Our world was once a vastly different place. To experience this won't hurt you, and there is nothing to fear. No principle of discovery in the theoretical sciences rises to a higher priority than predictive ability. Predictive ability, not so much in the sense of foretelling the future, but the ability to explain, and even better, to logically deduce known facts from a new vantage point. Our subject in this series covers hundreds of mythic and symbolic archetypes. And we unabashedly claim that every theme you would expect to find based on the events reconstructed here, you will find globally and in extraordinary detail. In previous segments, we briefly reviewed the role of the planet Saturn in the ancient creation legend, the myths of the Golden Age, Saturn as archaic sun god, a revolving crescent on Saturn cast by light from our sun, and supporting it all, the polar configuration of planets, remembered as the great conjunction or perfect conjunction of primeval times, ending in the catastrophic breakdown of the configuration, the global source of doomsday anxiety. In the full reconstruction, the two most active bodies are the planets Venus and Mars, whose stories we've barely begun to enumerate in this series. The advantage we hold with this reconstruction is that we can see the global symbolism in the light of a concrete celestial provocation. From that vantage point, the archetypes will fall into place like the pieces of a jigsaw puzzle. In fact, all of the recognized archetypes around the mother goddess and the warrior hero, plus many more that the experts themselves have missed, will trace to two planets in the polar configuration and their unique juxtaposition in world traditions. As a first step, we only need acknowledge the planetary identity of the mother goddess. The most fully documented ancient cultures consistently identify the goddess with just one of five visible planets, Venus, an enigma for which there is no accepted explanation. Ancient astronomies make crystal clear that Venus is the prototypical star goddess, consistently linked to the central, radiant eye, heart, or soul of the primeval sun, the very figure we've identified as the planet Saturn. A preposterous idea, but a historical fact coming down to us from the birthplace of astronomy in ancient Mesopotamia. Our reconstruction will show that myth-making imagination saw in the luminous streamers of the discharging Venus the animating life of the archaic sun god. But a critical turn occurred with the removal or departure of Venus from its appointed place. In the mythic language, this signified the death or disempowerment of the universal sovereign. That departure meant the loss of his animated eye, heart, and soul. With this departure, the discharged streamers of Venus took on a disordered, filamentary appearance, provoking global superstitions and astrological beliefs about comets, all traceable to the mythic prototype of comets, the planet Venus. These very events will fully resolve a universal paradox. The lovely goddess transformed into the angry or lamenting goddess, raging in the sky, her wildly disheveled hair trailing behind her. That is the archetypal image of the great comet, often portrayed as the flame-like hair of an angry goddess or of a raging lion. A serpentine or dragon-like form of the goddess recorded around the world will trace to the very same events, the spiraling form taken by the departing eye, heart, and soul. Always this female serpent form will lead us back to Venus as the great comet. The subjects are immense, and the brief notes we presented here as a first glimpse can only open the door to the vast library of evidence. We'll take up this evidence one theme at a time. But to hold the door open, we'll also need to see the connection of the universal goddess to the cosmic warrior. And to see this connection in its remarkably concrete texture, where everything has a visible referent. That will require us to look closely at the role of Mars in the evolution of the polar configuration, our next subject.